What's up guys, welcome to my channel. So today I'll give you a basic review of Zen X ROM on your Redmi K20 Pro. So don't waste time, let's boot. So guys, basically this ROM is based on Android 10Q and the security level is 5th June 2020 and here the perf kernel is used as a stock one. In case of launcher, here we get to see Pixel Launcher and which is the smoothest launcher from my side, and we don't get to see any kind of animation lags or bugs on it. Now in settings section, the VoLTE and Wi-Fi calling are working perfectly and the Wi-Fi and Bluetooth is performing well. After that, you will get a Zenhub option which is a basic customizer for the ROM, and all options are sorted in grid style. Now in status bar, where you can get a brightness control option and icon style changing option, clock style adding option, add battery bar option, and then the network speed over on status bar, and also you'll get a adding logo option. In the below you can get a Bluetooth battery status showing option, HD icon, 4G icon, data disable icon and more. If you select the quick setting option, then there you will get some modification tools for your QS panel. You can change blur intensity, QS accent, and you can add header images on the QS panel. And there you will get some presets images for it. In below you can get some more options to modifying the icons. After that you can get a notification option where you can modify the header notifications. Then in lock screen you can get some options to modify the lock screen style. You can change the charging animations, and in below you get an option to change the A4D icon. In below you can get screen of A4D enabling option, and let's see it's working or not. Yeah, it's working but it's taking time. In ambient display you will get a edge lighting option and you can change and modify its color. In navigations, you can modify the full screen gesture and shortcuts and more. Now in interface, here you can get a dark theme enabling option, and you can get a option to change the pixel launcher styles, fonts and the wallpaper. And also you can get a option to change the clock style on ambient displays. So here is some presets of it, so you can select it from here and you just have to apply it. Now in animations, you can change the QS styles animation style from here. In miscellaneous, you can get charger plug to wake the device and charging animation option, and here you can get a game mode option and it will turn on when you play a game, and it will disable the pop-up notifications and phone calls. In battery, you will get a smart pixel option. So basically what it is, it will turn your AMOLED display to TFT pixel style display, and you can enable it when you have to take your battery so long. And in ROM information panel, there is a system updater for you and it will give you the OTA updates of this ROM. In battery, you will get a battery logo and a graphical usage bar in it. Then you will get a thermal profile option where you can change the profiles according to your applications. After that you can get to see a battery saving options, adaptive battery options, and here is a ultra power saving option which is the new one here. And then you will get a smart charging option which is now available in most custom ROMs. And in below it's showing when you last full charge your phone and screen usage since full charge and battery temperature. In sounds you can get moreover all options which are available in other ROMs, and there is a direct sound enhancer, and you can enable the hi-fi audio and you will get some presets of the headphones. Now in security you will get the fingerprint and face unlock both feature, and both are working perfectly. So let's see the fingerprint, you can see that it's unlocking faster. Now in case of face unlock, it's also working perfectly and you will get an option swipe to unlock. So basically what it is, if you turn it on, then the camera will pop up only when you slide the lock screen. Now let's see how faster it's working. So I slide it up but the camera is not popping up. Oh, it's popping up after I unlocked by the pattern. So it's a little glitch here. Now just turn off the slide up option, then let's see it's working or not. So you guys can see that it is working perfectly, but there is a glitch on slide it up option, so you just have to disable that option to use the face unlock. Now let's see what tiles we get to see on quick settings. So first you will get a notification clearing option over here. Then in first QoS panel we get to see some basic options over here. Then in second row we get to see bedtime mode, gaming mode, caffeine mode, do not disturb mode, compass, DC dimming and this kind of stuffs. In third we get to see CPU info tile and also a direct tiles for dialer, camera and music. And here is a screen stabilization, and this seems to me a pretty cool features nowadays. And there is also calculator tile and a head up notification tile. Now in case of camera, you get to see the ANX camera 185 pre-installed on this ROM, and it's working perfectly except its portrait mode. When I click on the portrait mode, it will automatically turning on the front camera. So this is a little glitch over here, and I hope it will be fixed in next updates. Now in native root checker, all tester purged except the permissive SELinux SU exist, SU binary, wrong path permission. And in below you can see that it's showing as this is a rooted device. The safety net status is showing as passed, so you can use any kind of payment apps on this ROM. And also in Play Store it's showing this is a certified device. Now as this ROM is a L1 certified, that's why the Netflix is available on Play Store and you can stream that kind of stuffs over here. Now let's run some applications opening speed test. So the test is over and it's opening the apps quite faster. The RAM management of this ROM is also quite good because developers are giving focus to make it a optimized and daily usable ROM. Now let's see the benchmark result. So it scored 4421 on OpenGL 3.1 and on Vulkan it scored 3552. So it's a good measurable score on perf kernel. So after all of the tests and from my using experience, I can tell you that it's a perfect ROM for your daily use, cause it will give you a good battery life for day to day. But I can't recommend it for high level gaming because the GPU is underclocked here and it will not give you that experience which you expect from a K20 Pro. Now if you want to install this ROM, then let's see how to do it. So previously I was in MortalOS and I am switching from it, and it's a clone of MIUI, so that's why I hope it will help you to understand more. And the first thing first is, you need the bootloader unlocked and the recovery installed on your device. Then you have to power off your phone, and then you have to press the volume up and power button simultaneously until it's turned on into the custom recovery. After booted into the recovery, you need some files to download, whose link I already given in the description box. So first, download those files. Then you have to save those files on internal, or you can use a OTG pen drive for it. After that, you have to go to the backup section and you can take a backup of your current ROM from here. So after taking backup, you have to go to the wipe section, then select Delvik cache system and data. And if you are running on the current vendor, then no need to select the vendor. If you are not, then only select the vendor and swipe to wipe. After wiping this partition, you have to locate those downloaded files. Now if you are not in current vendor, then first you have to flash the vendor file, then the DFE file, and then the ROM. So I am already in current vendor, so I am flashing the ROM file directly here. So guys, I get the error 7 because I was in current vendor but the firmware was not supported for this ROM. So I have to flash the vendor plus firmware file again. Then I have to flash the DFE, then I have to flash the ROM. After flashing ROM, again you have to flash the DFE, otherwise you will be turned back into the recovery. After flashing all of those, if you want your phone as a clean device, then you can go to the menu, then the manage partition, then select data, then format data and type yes. And it will format all of your internals. And if it is the first time of your custom ROM, then you must have to do it. Then you just have to reboot into the system. And it will took some time to boot for the first time, so you just have to hold your patience here. So guys, I am successful to flash the ZeniX OS ROM on my Redmi K20 Pro device. So you can follow my process to get it on your device. And if you need any kind of help regarding this, then you can join our Telegram channel, I'll be there for you. So if you guys like my video, then do comment below, it will help me to do better. And like, share and subscribe my channel to get updates. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.